Why are you so overdramatic and emotional? I thought I was emotional.
Well, that isn't by this, this.
I know.
Rush, but yeah. See what?
But don't make it sound so now. You have a moment of silence, a moment of silence. All right, a moment of silence. All right, that's enough.
Okay.
So it's about that time for us to wrap up this season, the second season of The Buzz on the Go, of course, Whitney Trumpet. We are here, but we will be back soon. We cannot forget who made this amazing show possible as usual.
The sponsors.
Blink Blee Mobile.
The sponsors this time, so yeah.
Toyota and also Free Citizens Bank. But before we close off everything, I understand you had an encounter with...
Oh, well, now, don't even bring back. I now try my belly and I'll pay back together.
I heard you couldn't function.
Yeah, that snake, that experience.
But what about the tarantula? Like, I was not doing that, though, eh? If I was I was going to run.
I didn't go. At least the snake could have come around me, but I was like, yeah, so yeah.
Well, they will get to see that interview and so much more, because this is the last episode for season 2. So we're gonna take it. You take it away now, since you're feeling all right. All right, we'll take a break and we'll come back, okay? And when we come back, you'll see what went on with Trumpet at Toyota. It was Earth Day.
Earth Day.
One second. Yeah, yo. Yeah, yo. Moolala. Yeah, yo. Better have my money. Y'all should know me well enough. Better have my money. Please don't call me on my blood. Pay me what you want it. Balling bigger than LeBron. Give me your money. Who y'all think y'all fronting on? Like blah, blah, blah. Louis 13 and it's all on me. Nigga, you just bought a shot. Kamikaze, if you think that you gon' knock me. The Buzz is sponsored by B-Mobile, Toyota, First Citizens Bank.
Their impact has always been advice beyond banking. If you needed to speak to them beyond financial matters, I've always felt comfortable to speak to my manager or CSR representative. I think anyone who is setting up a business and they look at the success story of First Citizen, which is homegrown, I strongly believe that this is the model to follow. My name is Ashmeed Ali, and we are First Citizen.
They are ready to go with you. Any place, anytime. On the road, they're both intellectually appealing. Off the road, they can maneuver the rugged terrain. Go with them anywhere, anytime. The Toyota Hilux and Fortuna. Let's start here. Toyota, forever.
All I want, yeah. Only love, yeah. All I say, yeah. All I want, yeah. Only love, yeah. Yo.
Hey DJ, bust it through and then pull it over. If you're attentive, pull it over. Spread my love, cause we can't get enough. Baby girl, just start winding up. If the party not nice, then me not go. Just jump to the bass and the piano. Live like a vacation in Tilago. Listen this scenario, we doing it larger than life, larger than life. Spread love and then let it fly. Raise the levels higher.
Welcome to another edition of The Buzz. I'm here at Toyota Barataria for Toyota's second annual Earth Day. Now, earlier I saw a lady walk past with an iguana on her head. I don't know if she related to Ravi B. She went that way, so I will go this way to stay away from her. Now, I'm going to let you know all about Toyota's Earth Day, what it's all about. We're going to see some animals. I saw some cyclists passing earlier. We're going to find out what it's all about here at Toyota's second annual Earth Day. We're back here at Toyota's Earth Day, and I'm seeing a very interesting booth here at Trinidad and Tobago Field Naturalist Club. So I'm going to go into this booth and get some information as to what it's all about. Good day, sir.
Yeah.
This is the Trinidad and Tobago Field Naturalist Club.
Yeah.
Tell us what it's all about.
Well, this is one of the oldest environmental group in the Caribbean. It was founded on the 10th of July, 1891. And our mission statement is to foster education and knowledge on natural history and to encourage and promote activities that will lead to the appreciation, preservation, and conservation of our natural heritage.
Now I'm seeing a lot of things on your table here.
This is just a tip of the iceberg of our exhibit. Recently we had our exhibit at Country Club in Maravalli,
right,
and the exhibit was similar. So in our booth here we have a lot of things from the Trinidad and Tobago forest. Across here we have things like the monkey comb here. This is
the what?
Monkey comb. This
monkey
is from the forest, and monkeys were seen combing their hair with us.
You serious?
Yeah. And this
I could comb my hair with it?
Yeah. And this is another variety of the monkey comb. It grows on a vine. Mm-hmm. This one you could also use it as a bandeau for your hair and so on.
Oh really?
Ladies in the countryside use it as a bandeau.
Okay.
This is bay leaf or celement leaf.
Right, now I know about this.
This is the flower from the chatine. And this is a fruit hanging from a tree at UWE St. Augustine called the Kiglia Africana, or sausage fruit.
Can you eat this fruit?
No, this is not edible. This, it just falls to the ground and they put it in the bin. This is a palm here found at the beach in Toko, right? Forest Point. And this palm has drifted and it was taken to the National Herbarium at UWE St. Augustine. And they identify it as the Nipa fruticans, right? Either drifted from Venezuela or Guyana.
Oh, okay.
So we don't have large trees in Trinidad. This is Cassia fistula. It's used for medicinal purposes. And this is an orchid from Iguana Bay, Tobago, Qualatron biconotum. It just drifted, so we decide, well, look, it's good for exhibit and so on. This is Chinese tamarin here.
And this Chinese tamarind.
Chinese tamarind, it's edible. We have the trees in Trinidad.
Okay.
And this is pine cone from up in Mount St. Benedict.
Right.
And this is torsio, right? Or lofa. You have smooth and angled lofa. It's right. Edible when young. You can cook it and eat it.
And you use that to be too?
Yeah.
Good.
So this is the porcupine picker. Yeah. And we just have it in a bottle so students wouldn't pierce anybody.
It's oh, Lord, hey. Yeah, you had to keep that safe.
Fine. And this is Mami Sipo here, edible, right? You can have some at the end of the show here. This is Jennifer. This one here is Jennifer Americana.
You can make chow with us?
Not, it's more used like when it's ripe, right?
Oh, okay.
This is Sapodilla here.
All right.
Right, yeah.
You have any stinking toe?
This is stinking toe here. It's also called locust. The botanical name is Hymenia corabel, and it's edible. When it falls to the ground, the agouti would come and the hunters would be there waiting for the agouti.
What systems are in place to preserve all these things from our country?
We try our best at the TNT Field Naturalist Club. There are members who collect their specimen and so on, but we should have more museum in the country.
I agree.
We should have the specimen in this museum so the world can see what we have.
Do we have people who cultivate these things? Who?
No, there are some people, but it's more like not many. Right, yeah, not many. Right, this is crapo. It's not the amphibian.
This is a crapo?
This is from the forest, a tree from the forest. The lumber is used for making like board houses.
I'm not going to tell you it's looking like a crapo, you know.
yeah. Right? So it's a tree crapo and not the amphibian. This is the fruit.
Oh, okay. Right? Can you eat this? Because I know you can't eat crapo.
It's used for like medicinal purposes, like you grate it and so on, cough, cold, flu, whatever.
Okay, I never know you could eat a crapo for the cold.
This is donkey eye here. Donkey eye, and this is the pod which the donkey eye came in. Right? It grows on a vine. And this here.
This donkey eye, you know.
This is Suhari leaf here. You can also use it as a plate when you have weddings and
all right, right,
food.
Right.
You can dispose it of. Right. This young tree here is fat pork. And across here, this is a vine growing in the ground. This gives farmers a lot of problem. Right. It's not a sweet potato or cassava. Right. It won't boil. Right. It's also called Cambolium. And the botanical name is Stigmaphyllum convolvulifolium.
What does it do though?
No.
Nothing?
Nothing, yeah.
You can't eat it, you can't do nothing.
No.
Can't beat somebody with it now.
No. Right? And across here, this is sandbox. This is the one that you make the dolphin with, the earring.
Right, okay, okay.
This is the fruit. This is how it looks like before it splits open.
Right.
If this tape wasn't around here, with the heat of the sun, this would dehisce itself, right, and make an explosion. The seed inside, it's used as a powerful local laxative. Like if some friend or partner is giving you a problem and you pulverize this and pour it in that drink,
I could have this?
It send you to the washroom.
I think I want it.
Now exhibit only.
I think I'll keep this one for with me.
This is tonko bean here. This is edible, right? This is edible. This is a dried up cocoa here. This is castor oil. And this is the pod of the mountain rose.
I know a lot of people would hear of castor oil, but never saw actual castor oil.
Right, and this is one of our local corn here. Right. You can check the appearance and so on. These are butterflies collected by...
take a shot of the bottle.
And this is the fine leaf here. You can also use it as a bracelet, right? It's a pod from a tree. And it's called fine leaf. The botanical name is Pentacletra macroloba. And this here is bilimbi. It's edible. You can make pickles with this here. You can make a double sauce. You can boil it. And it's very acidic. You throw off the first water and then you add your sugar.
People make pickles with this?
Yeah.
This is a very exotic.
Yeah. It's the botanical name is Averhoa bilimbi and the family is Oxalidaceae. And this here is wild onion. This is a sort of an odd-shaped coconut.
Right.
This fruit here is not an orange.
It's not a mango neither?
No. This is Poteria guyanensis. It's from the La Fillette forest. Right? And this here, if you're going across Galera, this is the sea grape here. As this coloration changes here, it's sort of a sweet and sour.
No, I know sea grape.
If you're feeling upset or anything, this is the right thing, right? Cocoloba, uvifera, or sea grape.
I don't know the long name, I just know it as sea grape.
This is mahogany, and if you have about 10 or 15 mahogany tree in your land, you can purchase a new motor car.
You're rich?
Yeah. So this is very expensive, mahogany cedar. Yeah.
I can see one?
Yeah. And across here, this is a pod from the Mora, Mora excelsa. And this one here is the fruit from the Moorish palm, Mauritia flexuosa. This across here, this grows on a vine, and the botanical name is Sicania trinitensis, right? And this here now, if you're going across in Scarborough Crown Point, you must buy your Benny Ball.
Right.
This is what it looks like here.
This is what?
You shake the seed here.
This is what they make Benny Ball from?
You get the Benny Ball.
Okay.
And this here is a Jambi bead here, and this one here grows on a vine. Mm-hmm. And this is from a tree in the forest. So this is just a tip of the iceberg here.
Wow.
This is our, we have a BioBliss here. Mm-hmm. And it's our, we had our third BioBliss at Nariva. Mm-hmm. And the fourth one will be coming up in Charlotteville, Tobago.
So if someone wants to find out more about Field Naturalist, how can they go about finding out?
Well, we have our meeting at St. Mary's College, Port of Spain. It's 5:30 p.m. at the Audiovisual Room in St. Mary's College. And you can always check it out anytime. We have our lecturers and so on the environment.
Any information online as well?
Yeah. All the information online.
Thank you so much for all the information.
You're welcome.
We're here at the booth for the El Socorro Center of Wildlife Conservation, and we have someone here from the center. Hi.
Hi, good morning. My name is Natalie Mohammed. I'm the volunteer coordinator for the center. As you can see, we're the El Socorro Center for Wildlife Conservation, where our mission is to promote education, propagation, rehabilitation of all the local wildlife in Trinidad and Tobago.
Go ahead.
Today we have a couple of our animals that we have ambassadors for the center. We brought them out to display and to educate the public on the wildlife that we have found in Trinidad and Tobago.
Natalie, what is that you have in your hand?
Today we have a tarantula. It's called a pink toe tarantula. It's very friendly. We bring it to show everybody. When you see the tarantulas, don't kill them. They're not gonna harm you. They're not gonna hurt you.
It's very friendly.
It is.
Okay, we'll take your word for it, right? Now, tell us a little bit more about the other animals you have here.
Okay, so I'll have Ricardo come over. Ricardo?
Ricardo, my brethren.
Morning, how are you doing?
Yeah, good man. Good. I don't know what Natalie doing without him, but yeah. Anyhow, so Ricardo, tell us about the animals you have here.
Most of the animals we have here on display are rehabilitated animals, which are unable to go back into the wild, so become animal ambassadors.
Right.
So instead of putting them to sleep, we've trained them to be accustomed to people, the sun, the light, the noise, the vibration, and they represent themselves and they represent the center to teach people that these animals should not be crushed, killed, chopped, but loved and respected and just given their place. They want to live just like you and I.
So you keep these animals at the center for conservation?
Yes, these animals, the non-releasables, are kept as ambassadors and they reside down at the center.
Now, I'm seeing a big snake there. Do you keep this snake at the center?
Yes, she's a baby also. Next week is her birthday. She's going to be hitting 5 years old.
When she's a baby, can we take a look at what a baby looks like?
Let's bring it on and get a group hug with this baby.
A group hug? No, my friend.
We get to see how small this snake really is. She's only coming up on 12 pounds, 12 feet and 65 pounds. But she'll get to about 150 pounds and close to 20 feet. So, she's a baby.
What? So is Natalie really going for?
Yeah, we're going to bring her out. Man up. Run in the middle.
I am here with our baby snake. That is how many?
She's five.
She's five. Her birthday is next week. She's crawling on me. I used to love my job, but I don't anymore. It licking me.
I usually come to body bite.
So how much pounds could this snake grow to?
She can top out at about 150 pounds.
150 pounds, what's her weight right now?
64.
64 pounds right now, and she's licking me. Okay, that's it for the show for today. I wanna go home right now because I think I just wet my pants. It's moving. And moving, Ollie, all right, take it off.
The Buzz is sponsored by B-Mobile, Toyota, First Citizens Bank.
They are ready to go with you. Any place, anytime. On the road, they're both intellectually appealing. Off the road, they can maneuver the rugged terrain. Go with them anywhere, anytime. The Toyota Hilux and Fortuna. Let's start here. Toyota, forever.
Hi, my name is Evelina Bruce, and I'm the Youth Development Officer here at First Citizens. And now all that means is I'm the person that coordinates the sponsorships, events, and public relations for the group as it relates to youth development and education. Why is it important to save as a young person? It's important to develop good saving habits because sometimes saving is not something that comes naturally, especially in our society. We all like to party, we all like to lime, you know, we like nice clothes and nice things. And learning to save at a young age really sets you up for the future. When you want to get into maybe getting lines of credit, as you get older, you might want to get that first credit card or that first car, or, you know, eventually save towards a mortgage one day. All these things require sometimes down payments and securities. And so starting, like, having proper saving habits as a young person and as a child and growing up, it kind of gets you in that mode of always putting something aside. It's about always having a reserve on standby, and once you start developing that at a young age, and you could save towards little things that you might want to get for yourself, maybe, so you don't always have to ask your parents. I mean, that stays with you, and as you get older and you enter the world of work, you're able to, you know, save that first down payment and buy yourself a cool car, save that down payment and get yourself a mortgage. So that's why it's important to start developing healthy financial habits as a young person. It's important to save as a young person because the financial habits that you develop today is what is going to carry you through to the future. As a young person, it's important to start learning the importance of saving. When you get your allowance and so, it's good to have an account that you can probably put some aside at, and, you know, maybe save up to buy those cool things you might want to get for yourself, so you don't always have to ask your parents. And when you start that at an early age, it really lends itself to your adult life, because as you get older, your responsibilities get greater and you start looking at things like, you know, taking out a credit card, maybe buying that first car, saving towards a mortgage, and all these things require sometimes down payments and security. So as a child, if you start developing healthy financial habits and, you know, you learn about saving properly, it becomes that much easier when you get older to save towards these kinds of things. At First Citizens, we offer a range, of course, of financial products, including savings, investments, and credit. And the NEO Youth Savings Account is the account that we have geared towards our younger citizens. So it goes in three tiers, and they are Destiny, Aspirer, and Achiever. The NEO Destiny Account starts from age 0 to 12. The Aspirer is from 13 to 17, and the Achiever is from 18 to 25. So there are many perks to opening a new account. First of all, there's a low initial deposit of $50 TT or $20 US. And in addition to that, you get discounts at lots of, I think personally, awesome merchants like Bang Bang, Caribbean Jewelers, RIK bookstores when you need to get your school books, a bunch of other merchants as well. And there's also the added advantage of no ATM fees, which is excellent, especially as a young person. You know, if you're still getting an allowance, you don't really want any of that money eaten into by ATM fees. We at First Citizens are proud to be a part of the Buzz on the Go. And if you need more information about any of the products that I talked about today, you can visit our website at www.firstcitizenstt.com, or you can check us out on Facebook at First Citizens Youth.
The Buzz is sponsored by B-Mobile, Toyota, First Citizens Bank.
Breaking news. It's time you knew the facts. You pay $20 plus $3 for a $20 B-Mobile top-up card because we charge the VAT up front. Nothing more and no surprises. This way you get exactly what you pay for, the full $20 value of your $20 card. And if it's your first top-up of the month, make that $40 of value from a $20 card. At B-Mobile, you always get the value you pay for. And that is true talk.
Your wish is my command.
I wish for something really exciting. I wish I could explore the world of luxury. I wish for a dynamic experience on and off the road.
Your wish is granted. This is it.
The 2014 RAV4. Toyota. Forever.
Be a bear.
You tired, hold me. Welcome back to the Buzz on the Go with Whitney and Trumpet. Now, Trumpet had a fabulous time at Toyota's Earth Day. And speaking of Earth, we're on the beach. So we keep it linked because, you know, we're on the go. Easter is almost over. It's Easter Monday. And that means we need to bring you some Easter festivities that's taking place. Now, right now, we're on Maracas Beach opposite Uncle Sam's in Trinidad and Tobago. And, of course, it's all about Boom Champions Sand Dance. This is what they do every single year. People make their way down. Football is taking place behind me. And, of course, so much entertainment. But we're going to find out more exactly what is so great about sand dance that so many people throughout Trinidad and Tobago make their way right here on Maracas Beach. Now, I have one of Boom Champions' personalities, Cupid, with us. And, of course, he's going to let us know a little more information on what's going on the beach. I see you vibing already. And you're still working. You're in charge of work.
No, you don't know. Well, it's sand dance 2015. And you don't know here what it's all about. We invite all teams from across Trinidad and Tobago to come out to Maracas Bay for 2 days of fun. We're going to have 2 days of football. We have the normal, the preliminaries, which is normally on the Sunday, and then the Monday we have the semi-finals, as well as the knockout phase and the finals on one day.
So we missed out on Sunday?
Yeah. On Sunday we had the preliminaries. And of course today it's all about the knockout competition and of course the semi-finals, quarter-finals and finals.
From what I understand too, it has like this huge event that takes place after the football at night on a Sunday that goes straight into morning. Tell me a little bit more about that. Is it going on into today as well as we speak?
Every time after the football, we normally have that party right across by Uncle Sam's here. Of course, you don't know, yesterday we had it. It finished like about roughly like about 2 a.m. or 3 a.m. in the morning. But the good thing about it is that from the time we finish the football, we encourage every single person, that whether you be a spectator, whether you be a participant of the football, or probably just up here just enjoying yourself, just to come out and, of course, just enjoy the football and, of course, enjoy the after party across at Uncle Sam's. After this football competition in the finals, you don't know the final. Win the game and the semi-finalists, everybody, you see all these people around me, they're gonna come across.
It's free.
Oh God, it's free. We like Trini's like free things. It's free.
Well, that's what we're talking about. Since it's free, we're gonna enjoy ourselves for the moment. While we're here, we're gonna take in some football, take in some of, I know guys will love to see the bikinis. And girls, don't worry, I got you. It's the Buzz on the Go. Don't go anywhere.
Fix up. You want to get fix up. Fix up. You want to get fix up. Yeah. See the little youth and you want to rap.
The Buzz is sponsored by B Mobile, Toyota, First Citizens Bank.
I am a family man, minister. It means that you help other people improve their life by giving them confidence in themselves and in God. From where First Citizens come from, and determination and strength, they didn't give up. And that inspired me to say, well, I wouldn't give up also. I am Victor Cook. We are First Citizens.
Alright guys, so we're back. I hope you all enjoyed not only the situation, I could call it the situation,
yeah,
with
yeah,
you and the snake and the spider. And we got a taste of First Citizens and what they're doing for young people as well, which is a major plus. We need to support our young persons out there to, you know, continue doing what they need to do. And they have dreams, just like all of us had our dreams, and we're fulfilling it.
Right.
They needed that door to be open, and we got that opportunity. And well, Sundance, that was beach kills, it wasn't there. Because I heard you were sick with your belly, with the snake,
I couldn't make.
Yeah, so thank you to Boom Champions for allowing us to come down there and take in the festivities.
Yeah, that time?
Yeah, it was good. I didn't get to sweat though, that was the only thing. I wanted to play football.
What's this with you on the football?
I like football. So, I can't get a little blind touching you.
No.
Play. Okay, my bad. So, Trumpet, I shall miss you just for season two here. But you know, we see each other outside of this.
Yeah, but
that's a lie though. I don't see you. Because I invite you places, you don't show up.
No. Yeah. I'll try to make myself more present. No.
Yeah. Maybe?
I'll try.
See, when it's in deeper, what happens?
But no, the good thing about it though is that we're looking forward to season 3.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And we're coming bigger and better for season 3. And of course, we're going to close it off with fine style. Right now, we're on the Lady Young. And of course, you can see behind us the beautiful city of Port of Spain.
Yeah, they give it the pool.
We have to give it the pool. No, this is really gorgeous though. Yeah, not gonna lie.
It is. For real.
And you can see the sun setting and it's getting dark. So it's about the time for us to exit.
And to wrap season 2 of the Buzz on the Go.
Yeah.
So it was a nice one.
Until season 3, TNT, it was nice. Always remember, be pure and just and have God in your life. You shall see Trumpet, myself, Jamal, Aliza, Liz, come in the shot now. People need to see who's Rose.
Oh, come now, Rose.
Rose doesn't do camera.
Rose.
She said Rose doesn't do camera.
Rose
doesn't do camera, she does.
Yeah, that's our manager.
Yeah.
So, as we say in the TV world, that was a wrap.
That was a wrap. Right.
Yay. Oh, oh.
Give me that.
Now I see the struggle through our pride, and I see the passion in our eyes. It's a culture that could never be replaced. No, now all of the colors in the sky, keep them flying, keep them high. Is a piece of history from all creeds and races. So, oh, 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 I want to go where the music lives. Oh, oh, oh. Only so got to feel like this. Oh, oh. It's like a throw all my stress away. Oh, oh. And it's there I want to stay with you. And only you. Right there I want to stay with you.
The Buzz is sponsored by B-Mobile, Toyota, First Citizens Bank,